there's some universal agreements between all of us that I'd like to talk about today and demonstrate. By a show of hands, how many of you felt calmness as I was painting this? Okay, so for those of you that raise your hands, we've come to our first agreement. I also feel calmness when I'm painting. I feel stillness. I leave myself in a really interesting way when I'm painting. It's as though half of me is here, and the other half of me is somewhere else. Completely free of thought, free of worry. My name's Mario Garcia, and I'm a 26-year-old artist from Phoenix, Arizona. Demonstrating for you all is a form of art that dates back to the 7th century and has made its way all throughout the world. From Iraq, Iran, China, even places like Spain, Sudan, and India, and America as well. So it's actually a language. It's the Arabic language. And what I'm working on today is an example of Arabic calligraphy. And calligraphy in general has actually made its way into the street art scene. And for those of us like myself doing it in this manner, we like to refer to it as calligraphy, which is a blend of the classical script and the free form of graffiti. So back to stillness. I think it's important for all of us to have something in life, find something in life that brings us to that state of stillness. And that's something that my art definitely brings me to. So I'm going to add the word stillness in Arabic as the first word. The Arabic translation for stillness. One second. The Arabic translation for stillness is sukun. I think we could all agree that peace would solve a lot of our problems in the world today. A poem that I really love about peace by the 13th century poet, Islamic scholar, and Sufi mystic by the name of Rumi. He said, "Make peace with the universe. Take joy in it. Every minute, a new beauty." Peace is definitely also a state of being that I go into when I'm painting. So, peace will be the next word that I add. The Arabic word for peace is salam. How many of you believe in the power of faith? I believe that faith is the secret element that can make anything happen. If you're religious, if you believe in a higher power, you've got to have faith in it in order to witness examples of its existence. And even if you're not religious, you still have to have faith in yourself in order to see examples of your own potential. a verse from the Quran, the Islamic holy text that I love about faith, is in chapter 109. It's the last verse. It reads, "Lakum dinukum waliyadin," which means, "To you is your faith, and to me is my faith." To each their own. That's how I interpret that. So with that being said, I'm going to add the word faith as well. Let's see where I'm going to fit this in. Going to write two words for faith. This first one is iman, which means your faith or belief in whatever it is you believe in. And the next word I'm going to add also means faith, but more so like the path that shall. And that word is deen. So far, we've come to these three agreements. I think stillness, like I said, something we all need. We don't come to that enough in our lives. Peace is one of the best things you could offer yourself and others. And faith, you have to have it. You've got to have faith in your ideas, faith in your beliefs. So I'd like to keep going and see how much more we can come to agreement on. Honesty. I think honesty is one of the most important traits any human being could have. Raise your hand if you disagree. A verse from the Bible that I love about honesty. It's so perfect. It's in Ephesians 4:25, and it reads, "Therefore, having put away falsehood, speak words of truth with your neighbor, for we are all members of one body." When you're honest with others, you're honest with yourself. When you tell somebody a lie, you're also telling yourself that lie. And I think that's why we feel guilt and shame when we look somebody in the eye and tell them a lie and they believe it. Because we're lying to ourselves. We're all members of one body. So honesty, that'll be the next word that I add. And the Arabic word for honesty is sidq. The Arabic language. The word for friendship is sadiq, which derives from this word. I think this is great because I don't think any real friendship should be absent of honesty. Now, forgiveness. Hardest things to give somebody, with one of the greatest rewards. Imam Ali, who is the son-in-law of the Islamic holy prophet Muhammad, he had something so great to say about forgiveness. It's so small, so simple, but so rich. He said, "Forgive that which angers you for the sake of that which pleases you." Just think about that for a minute. Forgive that which angers you for the sake of that which pleases you. I think the grudges and the resentments that we carry with us in life are usually the things that hold us back from feeling joy in the things that we do enjoy or would like to enjoy more of. So with that, I'm going to add the word forgiveness. The Arabic word for forgiveness is maghfirah. Patience. The easiest thing to forget to have when life presents us with new challenges. Patience can keep you from demonstrating some of the uglier sides of being human. Patience can bring new ideas and solutions to your mind. Patience can keep you from causing irreparable damage to yourself and others. My art is definitely something that requires a lot of patience. I can't rush the process. The more patient I am, the smoother my lines are. My art is definitely the best reinforcement of my patience. So I'm going to add the word patience. And the Arabic word for patience is sabr. Patience, something that not enough of us have, but we all need it. I'm going to keep going. This brings me to my last point. I believe that beauty can be found in all things and in all people, regardless of your beliefs, your way of thinking, your lifestyle. I think that if your intention is set on finding it, you can really find beauty in all things and in all people. That's what my goal is today, is to show the beautiful side of something that we might not all be familiar with. So I'm going to add the word beauty, because I think it applies. So the Arabic word for beauty is jamal. Silence is so loud. I believe that everything is linked. We're all human, subject to the same human errors, vulnerabilities, and uncertainties. We all go throughout life feeling the same variety of human emotions. And with some of the bigger things in life, like the meaning of life, or what comes after this life for us, we all equally don't know what comes. We don't know what's in store for us. And I love this. I find this very beautiful, very humbling. we all share far more in common